4th of May, 1929, in Ixelles, Brussels, Belgium, Audrey Hepburn, or rather, Audrey Kathleen Weston, was a British actress and humanitarian. Hepburn was the daughter to Ella Van Heemstra, a British aristocrat, and Joseph Victor Anthony Weston, an Austrian descendant and Nazi sympathizer. Hepburn knew how to speak Dutch, English, French, Spanish, and Italian, and is not only widely recognized for her work during the Hollywood's golden age, but is still, to this day, a world-renowned film and fashion icon.
She's enchanting. I couldn't do it better myself.
Audrey grew up in a middle-class family and was known to have a very shy and withdrawn personality from a very young age. Her father was an Anglo-Irish businessman, and her mother was a member of the Dutch aristocracy. So financially, they were better off than other people. They weren't considered particularly wealthy, but they did have several residences. Audrey's mother sent her to a boarding school in England, where she threw herself into the world of dancing and moved to Arnhem to study. Not long after, when Germany invaded the Netherlands, where she was accepted into the Arnhem Conservatory of Music and changed her name to Edda Van Heemstra, after her mother, as an English-sounding name, was considered dangerous. However, in the following year of the Germans invading the Netherlands, Audrey was trapped and lived in constant fear of being kidnapped and taken to the military along with other girls. Audrey's mother sent her to ballet classes in their hometown, where they had performances known as black performances, where they performed in people's basements privately to help raise money for the resistance. As well as this, Audrey and other performers risked their lives by taking money and messages, stuffing them into their shoes to resistance contacts. Meanwhile, Hepburn's half-brother was sent to a German labor camp, whilst her other brother ran away to avoid the same future. These being examples of the many things Audrey did to try and help the Allied resistance of World War II, whenever and wherever possible, which was extremely risky considering that her uncle was executed for an act of sabotage. During the Dutch famine and during the war, Hepburn suffered from malnutrition, anemia, edema, and other respiratory problems, which caused her to resort to using tulips for their flour that they then used to make biscuits and cakes. She also mentioned having terrible stomach aches due to eating an entire can of condensed milk and porridge with too much sugar, which caused her devotion to UNICEF. Thanks to this, by the end of World War II, Hepburn had just survived, unlike the 20,000 other Dutch citizens, and she weighed just over 6 stone, the equivalent to 84 pounds, despite the fact that she was 5 foot 7 inches tall. A few years after the war, she decided to pursue an acting career. At first, Hepburn started off playing small roles on Broadway. One of was playing Princess Anne in Roman Holiday, for which she was nominated an Academy Award. Hepburn was considered to be too tall and too skinny to be a principal ballerina, so she continued on her job as an actress, as the New York socialite character, Holly Golightly, in Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Ladies and gentlemen, in New York City, Miss Audrey Hepburn in Roman Holiday.
I want to say thank you to everybody who in these past months and years have helped, guided, and given me so much. I'm truly, truly grateful and terribly happy.
Here are a few clips from one of her famous movies, Breakfast at Tiffany's.
You can always tell what kind of a person a man really thinks you are by the earrings he gives you. I must say, the mind reels.
It's like Tiffany's.
Tiffany's? You mean the jewelry store?
That's right. I'm crazy about Tiffany's. Hold this for me, will you?
And what do you mean, weather report?
Oh, there's just a message I give Mr. O'Shaughnessy. So you know I've really been up there. Sally tells me things to say like, oh, there's a hurricane in Cuba, and it's cloudy over Palermo. Things like that. You don't have to worry. I've taken care of myself for a long time.
The legendary little black dress that Hepburn wore in Breakfast at Tiffany's was auctioned off by Christie's for $920,000 in 2006. Audrey dated producer Michael Butler in the early 1950s and got engaged to James Hansen in 1952. But they didn't get married in the end as they both had extremely busy schedules and decided it wouldn't work out. Hepburn eventually got married to Mel Ferrer from 1954 to 1968, where they met in a collaborated movie, Ondine, and another with Andrea Doty from 1969 to 1982. She also had a relationship with Robert Walters from 1980 till her death.
Thank you.
had two miscarriages, one in 1955 and another in 1959. When she fell off a horse during the production of her movie. Due to this, Hepburn took an entire year of acting to make sure that her pregnancy wouldn't end in miscarriage again, her child being Sean Fair. However, in the duration from 1965 to 1967, Hepburn had two more miscarriages. Later on, Audrey Hepburn would have another child belonging to Andrea Dotti. He was born in 1970 and would be called Luca Dotti. Not only did Hepburn have a gorgeous outlook, she was also willing to take the time out of her busy schedule to help other people. During the last decade before her death, she dedicated the remaining years of her life to helping impoverished children in the poorest nations, like Africa, South America, Bangladesh, etc. Often these kids would have flies all over them, but without hesitation, she would just hug them. This especially shows how caring she was, as she wouldn't see herself as someone superior, but put herself in the shoes of those children. In total, she supported millions of children all over the world. She became a role model to many celebrities today, inspiring them to help others in need.
A lot of world to see.